All right, well, for the first time since early 2005, the state of New Hampshire has a new governor, Maggie Hassan, sworn in today at the State House amid smiles and cheers. But in her first address before the state and the legislature, she telegraphed that she'd be involved all right and perhaps willing to mix it up if she has to.
We are uniquely suited to seize the promise and opportunity that innovation presents.
It was an inaugural address that certainly had its share of optimism, but Governor Hassan did not shy away from an aggressive posture at times either.
Our population is aging, yet we pursue policies that are driving our young people out of the state.
Hitting notes on education, school safety, even marriage equality, Governor Hassan did cast a wide net, even signaling that the budget challenge that lay ahead will be no picnic.
Needs do not go away simply because we don't fund them.
That was a line that would later draw this response from Republican Senate President Peter Bragdon.
Yes. And that is assuming that there are people who say we shouldn't fund things and pretend the needs aren't there. And there's nobody that I know of that's in that position. So she was talking about something that doesn't exist.
Differences and similarities aside for now, it was an historic day in Concord. New Hampshire said goodbye to one governor and welcomed in a new one, who pledged that her leadership will reflect the people she now governs.
The people of our state collaborate and make things work all the time, and their elected leaders must be able to do the same.
Well, Governor Hassan stressed that there will be some tough choices to make in the next budget and pledged to restore money to the university system in exchange for a tuition freeze. She also said once again she would veto any broad-based tax that makes it to the governor's desk. Once again, a desk that now belongs to Exeter's Maggie Hassan.